Hey guys, so we're going to solve a couple problems using the z table. I'm going to give you the mean and the standard deviation of a normal distribution. How do we find the probability that x is less than 4 if the mean is 5 and the standard deviation is 0.6? Well, first we want to find the z score. So what is the z score? The z score is this value minus the mean over the standard deviation. So if we want to write it out, equals your x minus your mean over your standard deviation. So we'll be using this formula for all these. Well, 4 minus 5 is negative 1 over 0.6 is negative 1.67. So this is our z-score. So now we go to the table and look at negative 1.67. 6, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 0.0475. And then the z-score always returns less than, and this right here is asking for less than, so we are done. This is the probability that x is less than 4 on a normal distribution with a mean of 5 and standard deviation of 0.6. So I don't know if you guys want to pause it for a second, try the rest of these. So 4.2, same thing, 4.2 minus 5 over 0.6 equals negative 0.8 over 0.6, which is equal to negative 1.33. So we look up negative 1.33, 0.0918. And that's everything less than, but we're asking what's probably the x is greater than 4.2. So we're going to do 1 minus this. And that gives us 0.9082. So it's 90.82% that our x is greater than 4.2 if the mean is 5 and the standard deviation is 0.6. For this one, we want to do each of them, find the z of the two, and then subtract the difference, and that will give us the range in between them. So now we have our z-scores of 1 and 0.83. So we're going to check those against the z-table. So 1 gives us 0.8413. Negative 0.83. So we have a 63.8% chance of being between 4.5 and 5.6. Now let's do between 3 and 5. So now our two z-scores, negative 3.33 and 0. Negative 3.33 is 0.0004. And we know that the 5, a z-score of 0, should be 50% because it's going to be on the mean. So 0 gives us exactly 50%. And we want to know the space between the two. And that's the probability that's between 3 and 5. And for number 5, this is a trick question for these problems. In continuous equations, the probability that's exactly 4.0000000 is 0. Notice all the rest of these were ranges. And in order to have a range, it has a value. But an exact value, that means it can't be 4.00001. It can't be 3.999995. It's got to be exactly 4. And the probability of that happening is zero for these problems. So anyway, I hope that helped out, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.